Hey guys, welcome back. So today's video is going to be part two of the reusable items that are huge money savers. Today we are moving on into the kitchen, so let's just get straight on into the video. Washable sponges. Washable sponges can save you a ton of money. I have been doing this for years. Ever since I had my first place, I was so sick and tired of purchasing those disposable sponges that are at the dollar store. So I decided to invest in a washable sponge that lasts a little over a year. Again, I will have all of these items that I use and that I'm telling you guys about linked down below so you can check them out for yourself. There's so many different kinds of washable sponges nowadays. I do stick with the ones that I've always purchased, but there are all different kinds for everybody. There's different patterns, there's different material, whatever you prefer. You can put most of these in the dryer, so obviously you can put them all in the washer. Some of them can go in the dryer on low heat if you would like to do that. For us, we just hang dry our sponges out of the wash, kind of like your sponge always dries when you're done washing a dish. You wring it out and you put it on the side. That's what we do. It works out with us saving money along with helping the environment because we're not constantly throwing out old sponges. Unpapered towel rolls. This has got to be my favorite thing that I have purchased this year. Of course, I used to have these face cloths from the dollar store and those worked great as well. But now that I live with my boyfriend, I wanted something that's going to be a lot easier for the both of us, especially when there's two people in the house. He uses some of them as napkins. I use most of them when I'm cooking to wipe down the countertops. So they do cling together like paper towel rolls. But the best thing about these is that you do not throw them away. You put them in the wash, put them in the dryer, or hang dry, whatever you prefer, and you can just roll them back up and keep reusing them. There's so many different patterns. I get mine from marliesmonsters.com. I find theirs the cutest and they are the most durable for our lifestyle. Again, we use them for basically everything when it comes to the kitchen and when it comes to eating, along with packing lunch. We will wrap like our utensils if we're gonna go out and about. We'll wrap our utensils in that napkin and just take it with us, and then obviously we bring all the dishes and stuff home and wash it. It's that simple. The amount of money that people spend on paper towels each year is mind-blowing when you can just do this simple switch and save yourself some money and also help the environment at the same time. Silicone zip bags. I have seen these everywhere. I have yet to purchase them, but I know that they are huge money savers because when you have kids and you pack their lunch for school or wherever you're going out and about with them, people always use the Ziploc bags, the plastic ones. They're only like, you can only use them one use. Put your sandwich in, put your fruit, whatever you're putting in it. And then when the kids are eating, they throw it out. And there goes your money into the garbage. So your best thing to do is to purchase these reusable silicone Ziploc bags, however you want to call it, because not only can you pack sandwiches and stuff with them, but you can also freeze your fruit and stuff with them. So they're like multi-purpose use. I think they are such a great invention. I see them everywhere. I have yet to pick them up because I feel like we do not need that right now. I feel like they are most useful for people that have kids or for people that love to freeze a lot of fruit. So just think of that the next time you go to the store and you want to pick up some plastic Ziploc bags. Maybe look around the store and see if they have the silicone ones, because then you won't have to purchase those little bags for a long time. Vegetable drawstring mesh bags. I have seen this everywhere. I just think it's so awesome where you can go to the grocery store with them, put your vegetables that you are going to purchase, you can weigh it with them, and that's it, you're on your way. You don't have to put anything in any plastic bags. You can put that little vegetable drawstring bag in your fridge and that's it. It's super simple. They can go in the wash, hang them out to dry, keep reusing them instead of using those little plastic bags that you see at the grocery store, which you never know who touched it. So those little plastic bags have way more germs than your actual mesh bag, and again, you are helping the environment while saving money. Reusable napkins. Now, like the unpapered towel rolls, a lot of people don't really like to use those as napkins. Basically good for if you have kids. The site that I order the unpapered towel rolls has napkins, so they are a little bit more heavy duty. They're not as thin as the unpaper towel rolls. So if you are using paper napkins, now is the time to switch. There's so many different brands out there that sell these little reusable napkins, and it's the same deal like every other reusable item. Throw it in the wash, throw it in the dryer, or hang dry. It's just that simple to make the switch and save yourself some money. You can also keep some of those in your glove box in your car, so when you're out and about and you get some food, just use those instead of using the napkins in the fast food restaurants or the stores. Fabric bowl covers. I have been seeing a lot more recently this year, more than last year, and I feel like that's because everyone is trying to stay away from aluminum foil and the little like plastic wraps. But you can swap those two items out and still keep your foods really fresh with the fabric bowl cover. They have so many different sizes, so many different patterns that can suit your lifestyle. Again, I will have all of those linked down below for you. And also they do have like a beeswax one, but if you are vegan, I know if you want to stay away from that. So there's all different kind of options to cover your food instead of wasting it. Most of those things can go in the wash, or they can just be rinsed off in the sink and reuse them over and over again. Stainless steel water bottles. This is a no-brainer. I think we've all switched to this, but the reason why this can save you a ton of money is that stainless steel lasts forever, no matter how many times you throw a stainless steel bottle. And those are the things that are gonna save you money, the things that are not gonna break and that you have to keep repurchasing over and over again. So if you invest in a decent stainless steel water bottle, it's going to last you probably forever. And another thing is a lot of people get discouraged where if you don't drink water, then you don't wanna buy one of these. You don't have to just put water in these bottles. You can actually put hot stuff. So if you put cold, it's gonna stay cold for over 24 hours. If you put something hot, like hot coffee, hot chocolate, it's gonna stay hot for a while as well. So again, you can't go wrong with stainless steel water bottles. Silicone cupcake liners. As much as I love to bake, this is something that I needed because I feel like this is so much more healthier than spraying your pan with a ton of like canola oil or whatever oil. All you have to do is just put these little cupcake silicone holders in, put your cupcake mix or cornbread mix, pop it in the oven, and that's it. They come out perfect. They do not even stick on them. I don't know how, but it's healthier for us, along with it saving us money. Because if you guys remember like those other cupcake liners that you get at the store, the dollar store, or even when you buy a pack of cupcakes, those liners that you just unfold and then you just toss them away, it's such a huge waste, not just for your wallet, but for the environment. Again, they have all different colors and styles of silicone cupcake liners. I know most of them are dishwasher friendly, and sometimes you can just rinse them under the sink and that's it. Reusable sandwich wraps. This is something that I just came across and I was like, who comes up with this stuff? It's genius. They're perfect for lunches, they're perfect for leftovers. Vegetables, wrapping up some vegetables like cilantro and stuff in them, and I don't know, I just think it's a great invention. It's cheap to buy and it lasts for a long time. Reusable food storage containers. I've talked about this probably in most of my videos, and that is the glass ones. And that is not to purchase any more plastic Tupperware, not to save any more of those butter bowls that you guys are saving. Yes, I see you. My mom is super guilty of that. I think till this day she is. But saving those plastic containers, they don't do anything for you, and they are just horrible because they're not multi-purpose. When you purchase decent reusable food storage containers, like the glass ones, they can go in the freezer, they can go in the oven, they can go in the fridge, you can bring them with you to lunch, anything. Like, they do not break too. Like, I've dropped them so many times and they do not break. A lot of people get a little discouraged when it comes to having glass Tupperware because they feel like they are going to break. Trust me, they do not. I just gave three small ones to my sister, and she feeds the kids cereal in them. Like, when she goes camping, she'll put some cereal and milk and the kids eat out of them. Like, my nephew is 3, my niece is 7, and sometimes they drop them and they don't break. The only thing is the cover part. You want to be careful, the cover part cannot go in the microwave or anything like, or anything hot like that, because most of the covers are plastic. So, but the amount of money that I save with glass storage containers is insane. No more staining when I make pasta, because if you have plastic little Tupperwares, they all stain. Like, the red sauce never comes out, and then you want to throw them out and buy new ones because they're not aesthetically pleasing looking anymore, and they always look dirty. So it's a huge win situation when you buy reusable food storage containers that are glass. Reusable straws. I don't think I need to get more in depth with this. We all know about the whole reusable straw thing, where most of the straws that we use that aren't reusable end up in our oceans, which causes turtles and all of the other sea creatures to eat them because they think that they're food. And the sad thing about all this is that they end up in their stomach because there's a ball of plastic in their stomach, or they just end up dying because they choked on it. So I'm hoping that one day the world would stop making these plastic straws and we can all just stick with our stainless steel straws or the bendy straws that you can clip onto your keychain. My boyfriend and I only use stainless steel straws. Again, with stainless steel, it's going to last forever. So the minute you buy stainless steel straws, you're never gonna have to buy another straw again, trust me. And most of those packages come with like a little cleaner where you can get inside of them, and that's it. It's super easy to clean. Most of them are dishwasher friendly. You can take them on the go. It's just, it's well worth it. Not just to save money, but also to save the animals from eating those horrible disposable straws. Like, we need to cut out as much plastic as possible, you guys. Reusable coffee baskets. I am not a coffee fan, but if you drink coffee every day and you're spending a ton of money on those little K-cups or coffee filters, maybe now is the time to switch to reusable K-cup filters or reusable coffee filters. There's so many of them on Amazon, and when you're done using them, you can wash them and reuse them again. I used to constantly tell my boss at my old job we should switch over to, you know, the reusable coffee filters. It will not only save the company a ton of money with buying filters, but it will also help the environment. And of course, they all thought I was crazy. But I'm letting you guys know that there are such thing as reusable coffee filters. So if you are a huge coffee drinker and you are not only spending your money on a ton of coffee, but you're also spending money on the filters and stuff. So maybe like swap this one out and save some money on this side, and you can still keep your coffee. Homemade countertop cleaners. Now, these are the DIY cleaners that are efficient, they have antibacterial properties in them, and they're super easy to refill each time, so you're not wasting your money on commercial plastic bottle products. So what I do is I have two glass spray bottles. They're both labeled. One is labeled antibacterial spray and the other one is labeled glass cleaner. The antibacterial spray that I use to clean the kitchen counters and stuff is made out of half peroxide and half water. Sometimes I will add maybe a little bit of lemon juice in it to give it a scent, and then I'll just clean the countertops and that's it. And then once when it empties out, I just refill it over and over again. Same thing goes for the glass cleaner as well. And you can use that homemade antibacterial spray on the microwave, inside the microwave, you can use it on your fridge. It's just great for everything, and it's one less thing to buy. Stainless steel mesh tea balls. This is going to save you a ton of money because of the fact that you're not going out and purchasing those, you know, store-bought tea bags that who knows what kind of herbs that they use. So it's best to make your own homemade tea. That's what my boyfriend has been teaching me. He grew up with homemade tea. I never did. So now he's shown me that if you boil some like anise, if you boil some cinnamon sticks, some peels of lemons or oranges, you have your own homemade tea along with other herbs, and you can put it in a little mesh tea ball as well. So if you do not want to have a whole pan of tea boiling, you can just have, you know, a little cup of hot water, put the herbs that you are going to boil in that little ball, and there you go, you have your tea. Once when you're done, you can wash out that little stainless steel mesh ball and use it again the next time you want a cup of tea. Popsicle molds. I've already showed on Instagram the popsicles that I have been making lately, the strawberry banana, strawberry mango, strawberry pineapple. I always use strawberries because I love them. But there's so many different flavors that I'm constantly coming up with or trying out on Pinterest with these little popsicle silicone molds. It's so much fun to do also with the kids. And the best thing about these is that you are saving money, helping the environment as well. But another great thing about these is that you know what's going into these popsicles. You're the one making them. You're the one that knows every little ingredient that's going into them. So there's no like artificial flavoring or natural flavoring. You guys do not even want to know what natural flavoring means. It's just look it up. So all the ingredients that are going into your popsicles is all fresh, homemade from you. So again, I'm still trying out different recipes. The best way to go about the juice part is you can add your own juice if you make your own juice, or if you buy your own juice, you can add that. What I like to do is I put some strawberries on a pan, medium heat, add a little bit of coconut sugar, add a little bit of water, and then you have some natural strawberry juice. And I will add that into the popsicle so that can like form it all together. So you still have that nice sweet taste, but with chunks of real fruit in these strawberries. And also, you don't have to use fresh fruit. I use frozen because it's cheaper. And I mean, we also make smoothies, so I can do popsicles with it along with making smoothies with the frozen fruit. Anyways, you guys, I really hope you enjoyed this video, and I will catch you in the next one.